Good morning, friends, from beautiful, sunny, and warm Reno, Nevada. I slept amazing last night in my $26 hotel room at Harrah's. And now I'm up getting my day started, and first thing I'm gonna do today, I need breakfast. Now, confession, I've actually never been to a casino gambling city like Reno. I've never been to Las Vegas. But one of the things that I think about when I think about cities like this are super cheap food, super cheap breakfast, kind of that old school Las Vegas dining experience. And there's a place right across the street that has a sign that I think sounds perfect to start my day. $5.99, steak and eggs. Yeah, I'm definitely going here. So here we are at the Top Deck restaurant where they have the $5.99 steak and eggs. I'm not sure what else they have. Oh, they actually have a ton of stuff that is actually pretty cheap. Two eggs any style, hash browns and toast for $5.49. That's not too bad. But I think the steak and eggs, $5.99, is what I'm here for. Just kind of flipping through the rest of the menu, and they do have a steak and lobster for $11.99. That is crazy. So you can see the inside of this place, kind of old school throwback. I'm sitting here at the counter, but there are a whole bunch of booths and stuff back over that way. All right, you guys, breakfast is served. Steak, hash browns, two eggs. I got my egg scrambled and toast. I went with rye toast. And they even got my steak pretty right. I ordered it medium rare, and I'm not gonna lie, that looks pretty perfect. Well, that wasn't terrible. And honestly, you guys, look at that. $5.99 plus tax, $6.49 for steak, two eggs, hash browns, and toast. I don't know how you could possibly beat that. After breakfast like that, I'm not sure if I'm ready for the day or if I want to go take a nap. I can tell the vacation has officially set in because I did something this morning that I honestly never, ever, ever do. I just realized a couple minutes ago, I don't have my phone with me. I've been without my phone for about 45 minutes or an hour, which never, ever happens. So I left the hotel room, totally forgot my phone in there. That means my mind officially on vacation. Here is Harrah's where I am staying, all right there. And then you can see right across the street is that famous Reno, the biggest little city in the world sign. And a lot of the larger casinos are right here on this street. Here's the El Dorado. I think right up there is the Silver Legacy. So now I'm here checking out Circus Circus, and it's actually really fun inside. You can see a ton of like carnival games, sort of feels like a midway in here. You know, I'm actually not a big gambler. I don't mind gambling, it's kind of fun, but I treat it like entertainment, so I'll take a set amount of money and then plan on just losing that. Kind of like going to the movies. When Sherri and I go to the movies, I know it's gonna cost us 60 bucks. That 60 bucks is gone, but it was worth the experience. That's kind of how I approach gambling. When I lose my money, it's gone because it was all about entertainment. Right across from Circus Circus, there's actually this kind of cool public art area. It's called the Reno Playa Art Park. You can see there's just a whole bunch of different public art pieces in here that you can walk around and check out. You guys know how much I love public art, how much I love graffiti, how much I love all of that kind of stuff. So this is definitely my scene. And over here, there's a sign on it talking a little bit about this. This is interesting. It's actually a Burning Man Global Arts Grant recipient. So Burning Man, obviously a huge, I don't know if I call it a music festival, a culture and arts festival, whatever it is. Stuff like all of this is huge there. And so apparently they have a grant program that lets them do this kind of stuff in other locations, which I kind of love. Also, this is interesting. All of the sculptures in here are actually for sale. While I love them a lot, I don't know where in the heck I would put them, and I'm pretty sure Sherri would not let me bring one home. Confession, I did gamble a little bit at Circus Circus. I started with $40, I left with $90, so I made $50, which basically covers my hotel for both nights here in Reno. So I'm gonna stop gambling and call that a huge, huge win. I'm walking by one of the pawn shops right here in downtown Reno, and I look in the window and they have this Green Lantern little print that is signed by Stan Lee. How cool is that? Looks like it's from 2006, and it has the certificate of authenticity right there with it. I don't know how much that is, but I may go inside and ask just to get an idea.
So just went inside. The signed Stan Lee print was $250. I don't know if that's a good price or a bad price. Honestly, for a signed Stan Lee piece, I didn't think it was that bad.
So this is kind of crazy. I didn't notice this earlier. Right here is that famous Reno sign. There's a hotel right across the street from Harrah's, right by the sign. And I thought this was just decoration. And then I realized, no, it's actually a rock climbing wall all the way to the top Are you kidding me?
There is absolutely no way. So, you know, the whole point of today in Reno, I had nothing planned because I wanted a day of relaxation. And so honestly, this is exactly what I wanted to do.
Hanging out by the pool, it is a beautiful day. I'm about to go get in the water. I've got a book that my friend Mikey gave me that I'm gonna read for a while.
And honestly, just sit outside in the sun, do nothing, and relax.
Okay, confession, I just woke up from a nap. I swam at the pool for a little while, laid out in the sun. I was like, I'm kind of tired. I'm gonna go back to the room and just lay down for a couple minutes. And I'm now awake again. But I guess that's awesome, because again, the point of today was relaxation. But now, I'm gonna go out and explore a little bit more.
So I was looking online at things downtown here in Reno, and I found this place called Antiques and Treasures. And you guys know, that totally sounds like something I am into.
This is totally the kind of stuff I was hoping to find in an antique store in Reno. Lots of old casino, like ashtrays, lots of old decks of cards from different casinos, just old gambling, Nevada kind of stuff. Very, very cool. This may be one of the coolest pieces I've ever seen in an antique store. A roulette wheel and table used at the Pioneer Inn here in Reno. The Pioneer closed in 1999. The table, wheel, and chips all still intact. $8,250, but this is amazing.
That was actually a pretty awesome antique store. Totally glad I stopped there.
So I'm walking out to dinner and I come across this game in an arcade here in Harrah's. You guys, this was my absolute favorite game growing up at any arcade. I cannot even tell you how many times I played this amazing, amazing game. This is like such a flashback even to see one.
So it's about dinner time and I'm actually meeting some of our viewers here in Reno for dinner. You know, when I put out on social media and asked you guys for places that I needed to stop and eat and sights to see, this was one of the places that I was told to go here in Reno. It is the famous Nugget Diner.
And the Nugget is famous for a burger called the Awful Awful. You can see voted gold medal winner for the best hamburger in Reno. But the place that I first heard about it was actually here on the Travel Channel's Food Wars.
The Awful Awful, a pretty famous burger in Reno apparently, and there are a couple of versions of it, but this is the winning version. Honestly, I'm so excited to try it.
So what exactly is an Awful Awful, you might be asking? Well, it's awfully big and awfully good, that's what they say. It's a half pound burger patty with a full pound of fries. Oh my goodness. Okay, so the Awful Awful was just delivered, and look at how, first of all, the onion bun looks amazing. And there's just kind of everything on there. There's the half pound patty and all of the fries.
This looks awesome. So let me give you an update on the Awful Awful burger. That thing was so, so good. Sometimes when you have like a novelty burger, you know what I mean? Like it's a big food challenge or something like that. The food actually ends up being just okay because it's more about the novelty. Not so with the Awful Awful. It is delicious. I totally finished the whole burger. However, the worst part, I don't want to say worst, the most difficult part is the fact that it comes with 1 pound of fries. And after you've had a half pound burger, all of the toppings, that delicious onion bun, a pound of fries is like a mountain unable to be climbed. So finished the burger, did not finish the fries, but had so much fun getting in, sitting to talk. And you guys, I think we've said this in the vlogs before, it really is getting to meet you in person, getting to know the LeggLife community, meet our viewers, means the world to us. So to get to sit down and talk for, I don't know, an hour, hour and a half or so, absolutely highlight of the night. But I've got to show you, they gave us a couple of gifts, and look how cool these are.
First of all, look at this awesome pair of ears for Sherri. And then these, you guys, they made these for Effie Gifts on a recent cruise. They are build your own Forky kits. What? They gave me two of them, so Sherri and I definitely gonna be using those when I get home.
And also, they're booked on the LeggLife viewer cruise, which continues to blow my mind that so many of you guys have booked that cruise with us. So I loved the fact that I got to hang out with them tonight, but also I know we'll get to see them again in September of 2020 on a cruise with so many of you. Now the night is still young, it's only about 8 o'clock and it is my last night in Reno, so I've gotta go out and do stuff.
So as we saw earlier, there's a ton of cool art here in Reno from Burning Man. Here, a few more pieces. This is a giant
believe, statue, I guess you'd call that. And then over here, this piece actually may be the coolest one I have seen. It's called Space Whale. It's a giant whale with stained glass that's lit up from the inside. This is such a cool piece. So Space Whale, and then the Believe sign, which is actually back up over there, are right here in the Riverwalk area. The river actually runs all along here. You can see bridge right there. But then this plaza is obviously used for skateboarding by a lot of the locals. Kind of cool, love seeing this.
Reno, you're kind of impressing me.
And then right across the street from Space Whale, if you want to get married, there's a wedding chapel.
Good morning, friends. It is my last morning here in Reno. I actually just checked out of my hotel, about to get in the car and start my journey up to Oregon.
So one final look at the downtown Reno area where all the casinos are.
Honestly, I didn't know what to expect from Reno. I've never been here before, and it exceeded every expectation I had. I actually had a really, really fun time. It was nice to relax by the pool, to get some rest yesterday, but also there was like so much stuff to do, which was great. But now, I have the longest day of driving ahead of me of the entire trip. So I need to get on the road.
Well, I missed the sign, but I am now entering California. So that is state number 6, I think. Yeah, that's the 6th and final state I will be in, because after California, I'm into Oregon, which I've already been into, and then back to Washington, which I've also already been to. So this, my 6th and final state. And this is what it looks like as soon as you cross the border from Reno area into California. I just had to pull over, you guys, because it is absolutely beautiful. I'm going through this pass, and just as far as you can see, it is just mountains and fields, and I don't know, it was just too beautiful not to stop and share. I just entered, I think it's pronounced Modoc National Forest, and the landscape has definitely changed. We're starting to see some bigger trees, more mountainous terrain. It's super pretty up here. So I just came down through this mountain pass that I've been going through for a little while, and you can see straight ahead that snow-capped peak right over there. That is Mount Shasta. That's kind of fun. I actually didn't know that I was gonna see that on this drive. 100% of the time I visit Oregon and I go to fill up my gas, I forget that they have to fill it up for me. So I pull up to the gas tank, I open my door to get out, and then the guy's like right there and I look like a moron. All right, friends, longest day of driving yet. I'm exhausted. I actually ended up driving all the way up to the Portland area. So it ended up being almost a 10-hour driving day. Wow. I need to go to sleep, so this is where I'm gonna end the vlog. Love you guys. Thanks for following along on my road trip. The next road trip vlog will be the last one, but I'm pretty excited about what the next vlog has. We'll see you guys in the next Legg Life video.